What is up, gamers?
In this video, I dive deep into chainmail armor. A lot of people claim that chainmail is a waste of iron and should never be bought. I decided to put this to the test and find out if chainmail armor is actually useless. My findings were actually pretty interesting, and I suggest you stick around until the end of the video to see what I find. And as always, only a small percentage of my viewers are actually subscribed. So if you like what you see, feel free to subscribe. It's free, and you can always change your mind. With that being said, enjoy the video. Is chainmail armor really that useless? Should you actually never buy it? Well, the answer isn't actually a simple yes or no. I looked into the opportunity cost of buying chainmail armor. What could you buy instead of chainmail that would be, in theory, a better use of your resources? Here are some things that cost the same amount as chainmail armor, which is 40 iron. I came up with 1 fireball, 160 blocks, full tools, and 4 stone swords. While full tools is more valuable as tools are almost required to break beds, you only need to purchase them once. Stone swords deal 0.5 more hearts to a player, and chainmail armor defends against 0.5 more hearts, and chainmail armor stays with you after death. 160 blocks is not a purchase anyone really makes all in one go, so for that reason I can't really say it's more valuable than armor. And as for a fireball, to be fair, it may actually be a better purchase. They are arguably the best item in the game, and chain armor can't really compete. However, chainmail armor is a permanent purchase, whereas 40 iron will only get you 1 fireball. Of course, different players will value these items differently, but if you value armor over any of these items, then chainmail might be for you. But first, we need to look at the value of chainmail armor in comparison to its biggest competitor, iron armor. Here, we need to make a very important distinction. In Bed Wars, there are two types of maps, slow and fast iron gen. Fast iron gen gives 3 times the amount of iron as slow, but gives the same amount of gold. In 1 minute, a slow iron gen will give you 32 iron and 8 gold, while a fast iron gen will give you 96 iron and 8 gold. With that out of the way, it is easy to say that buying chainmail armor on a slow gen map is most likely not the best option. However, on a fast gen map, the answer isn't so clear. For every 1 gold you get on a fast gen map, you get 12 iron. This means that iron armor is worth approximately 144 iron, which is 3.6 times the cost of chainmail armor. With this logic, iron armor should be 3.6 times better than chain armor, but this isn't the case. When put to the test against one another, chainmail and iron armor see little difference. While yes, iron armor did perform better, it was not 3.6 times better. In fact, against a sharp diamond sword, the two armors performed exactly the same. This tells us that chainmail armor is a better value on fast iron gen maps. Now we have to look at chainmail's second biggest competitor, Gapples. Gaps will give you regen 2 for 5 seconds, which is 2 hearts, as well as give you 2 extra hearts of health, all for 3 gold. On slow gen maps, gaps are the clear winner. However, on fast gen maps, chainmail is yet again a better value. Each hit guards against 0.5 more damage than leather, and you never die before 4 hits. This is at least 2 extra hearts per life. Thus, having chainmail armor gives you just as much, if not more, health than having leather with a gap, and it stays with you after death. While the cost of chainmail armor is slightly higher, 3 gold for a gapple is equivalent to 36 iron on a fast gen map, the fact that chainmail stays with you after death more than makes up for the fact that it costs 4 more iron, which is a negligible amount on a fast gen map. So, is chainmail armor a good idea? The answer is sometimes yes, sometimes no. In any slow gen map, this is not a good idea. The price of chain relative to the iron spawn rate just makes iron armor the better investment. However, chainmail armor is sometimes a good idea on fast gen maps. At the beginning of the match, gold is a rather scarce resource, while there is a surplus of iron. Buying chainmail armor in the early parts of a Bed Wars game is actually a good idea. However, once you take out your first base, you will have another generator to loot and gold becomes not as scarce, making iron armor the better purchase. Chain armor is best if you're someone who struggles with taking out their first rush, as it gives you a slight edge over your opponent and you can save your gold for TNT.